In the future, the end of racism and feminism. Yes, I know it's ambitious as a title, and yet it is the most likely prognosis. Welcome to this video. Stay until the end, please. I give you an indication to understand how everything can quickly change in France in the following summer. So if you subscribe to this channel, you know I'm French and I improve my English in each video, and you remember that I had announced several times that the COVID disappears from the mainstream media at once. And well, abracadabra, we are here now with sadly the murder of Mr. George Floyd. And in the media, no more COVID, and also no more need to make mea culpa, no more need to explain all the false numbers, no more need to talk about the viral terrorism of the states, the poor care of the sick, and the haste on the economy. So it's so easy to do like that, and everybody is observing it. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, please do it now, because it will save you a lot of time in the present by well anticipating the future and your future. And here, in short, I want to observe with you that this movement and demonstration around the murder of this colored man are under the guise of an anti-racist fight from near or far, and of course we all felt concern. But watch with me, where is the trap? Take for example a worthy cause, health. Take health for example, and the fight against a disease for example, and then arbitrarily ignore all the other, and then give the illusion of doing something when in reality we do the opposite by taking advantage of it to vampirize the energy of the crowds. And what is it? It's mass manipulation, it's perverse manipulation. And this is what we have known for decades and in a crescendo way worldwide. And this is also what must disappear and what is disappearing now. So here I give you the example with the worthy cause of health and COVID. Pretext of protecting the population, actually, what you do, you eliminate discreetly old and sicker people, and you indebt good being able to lay hand of their capital, which is depreciated by the crisis that you create yourself. You see the manipulation? Yes, I know it's thing. Manipulators believe that they are clever, but they are just possessed by the evil one. Divine intelligence let them do so that they simply perish where they are seen. In short, a manipulator is always a loser at the end. And on the other hand, if you don't watch out, if you are not aware of this, it can damn rot your life in the meantime. This is why I do this video, so to help you to not go into this trap. So you do the same, it's the same with racists, it's the same under the pretext of commendable cause. You are helping to destroy living environment, cities and peaceful coexistence by amplifying the hellish circle of victim instead of pacifying it. Observe it, instead of respecting the freedom of the citizen and to push their immune system positively, it's a virtuous circle, it's also called common sense. No, you do the opposite, you manipulate in a vicious circle. You confine the population, you deprive from light, from social life, from economic, from nature, to weaken the immune system, the body and the mind of your citizen. Observe to this mechanism in the context of racism. Instead of structuring the economic development of a population in a precarious situation, which lead to crime, you put pallets of brick at the disposal of the demonstrator on their route. You can shake it. It's a practice well known by the team of Mr. Soros. We put Mr. Soros here if you want to check. There are many videos on YouTube on this subject that even every people in America show. In France, for example, we allow Protestants to the support for Black Lives Matter, and the government bans the demonstration of caregivers. And curiously, there is no resurgence of virus after all those huge demonstrations, for example, in Berlin. So we block the world economy in 3 months for 3,000 deaths, falsely attributed to COVID-19, and we have done nothing for decades for more than 3 million children who die of malnutrition worldwide every year. You see where the problem comes from, the manipulation? You see that this is manipulation? Same phenomenon with women. Under the pretext of feminism, we push women to work, and this gradually become essential in the view of the family economic situation, without ever helping women to correctly manage their domestic life, their child, and their business life. And this is the famous double penalty. You are sick, we avoid taking good care of you. For example, in France, glyphosate is authorized and chloroquine prohibited. You are black, in a precarious situation, we destroy your city and your shop without helping you on the front of your economic situation. You are a woman, we block your creativity by transforming you into a workhorse between your professional life, your domestic life, and all the contraints you can have if you are mad enough to have kids with the school and all the aesthetic and social contraint. Do you picture it? This is that mass manipulation which is running out of steam today and which in its final moment appears horribly in bored deadline. You know that I grew up with a perverse manipulative mother, and it's a very good choice when you want to understand the matrix from the inside and know how to outsmart its traps. A manipulative parent will always make distinction between his children on the pretext, of course, of equality. And it's a very well-known principle. You see, for example, my mother keep repeating all day long that she did everything to treat us, my brother and me, on an equal footing while she was openly doing the opposite. And equality is a beautiful idea and also a trap in the hand of the manipulators. Two children, even twins, are different, and they have and will have a different story. One day one will be lucky and the next day the other one. So it's part of their life experience, and when you think about it, this is really the nature of life. And wanting everything to be equal is a manipulative trap. Women and men are complementary. The word injustice, to my point, must replace the word equality. And these are injustices that need to be repaired nowadays. So the quest for equality is perverse. Nothing is equal on earth and elsewhere. Everything is complementary to strive to a balance. And to fix all the injustice, we have to do something crazy for the time. Do you want to know what? Because it's very simple. Okay, I give it to you. So you have simply to put the notion of respect back in the spotlight. Respect for the individual, self-respect, respect for others. And it is always respect linked to identity, linked to the soul, that protects from manipulation. Who am I before I am a skin color or a woman or a child? When you are the victim of injustice, it is unfortunately a long story, not from yesterday, and the wound is deep. Look, for example, at the history of the black people in the United States. Look also at the woman's economic history. The wound is deep, and the healing must be just as deep. Everything being focused on restoring self-respect is the solution. How do I already talk to myself? How do I treat myself? Am I fair with my deep self? How do I speak to myself internally every day long? Think about it. Do you feel? So this answer is the key to healing, to the great healing time we are living now. So let's change in ourselves, and the world will change too. Exit manipulation, exit the abuses of power, exit civilizational and societal injustice, exit the parents in great difficulty, and so exit the great difficulties of their children by ricochet. So small daily injustice can persist as reminder of what we owe to ourselves, as a gift, as an affirmation of our identity and the respect we need to reinforce every day. So this is normal. If you learned it by chance, you know, the chance that are not. I need to present myself. My name is Galate. I am futurist and I analyze the present and the past to establish reliable forecast in broad outline for the future in general, but also the particular future of a person, of a situation, of a business. I have prepared two shares to help my contemporary. Here is the link to Futurology session for entrepreneurs, because entrepreneurs nowadays lack visibility and need lighting. And these appointments are one-to-one, and they are also excellent for startup. I have a lot of clients in startup world, and they compare me to the Oracle of Matrix, and I love this because this is really an image, a good image of my work. So the link is here, also in the description. And if you find my argument useful, and if you want to accelerate your evolution in a positive way, I have prepared for you a private sharing where I summarize and I synthesize 20 years of good tips, very good tips to fulfill your life in the present, to respect and to be respected. And suddenly you too can better, being well in the present, anticipate the future and your future. This private sharing is called Reinventing Yourself. You can do it simply in 3 weeks. And then you are in great shape and you are really more confident in the future in general and in your future. So everything is here, also in the description. Please like, share, comment this video, and stay after the jingle because I share with you what can set fire to the powder in France. Again, thank you to stay until the end. And observing the situation, you see, I tell myself that there is no chance that the situation is particularly unfair for restaurant in Paris and for restaurant in France and also in other country. But if you see France, the restaurant is part of the revolutionary circle, and all the restaurant movements start with the French First Revolution. And I say first because we are going to live in France a second revolution. I reassure you, this will be much softer. The second revolution will be soft. And curiously, the economic injustice that is done to restaurants in France, it's a trigger. And it's really important to see that when you touch to the French art of living, to good food, to good wine, you touch to the soul of France, and for sure you wake up dragons and unicorn and trumpets. So to be continued, let's all observe the seconds of the event in France, because all this revolution can spread worldwide. And cheers to you, because it's my birthday today. Cheers.